Good morning all. I am Sankara Reddy, working as an assistant professor in the Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering in Bharat Institute of Engineering and Technology. Today, I would like to discuss number systems in digital system design subject. First, let me talk about system. System is an interconnection of physical components which performs a specific task. So here there are three types of systems. One is digital system, analog system, and mixed signal system. So in digital systems, the system takes only digital signals and process the incoming digital signals and gives the digital signals as outputs. So this is my digital system block diagram. Which takes digital signals as inputs, digital signals as inputs, which process the incoming digital signals and which gives digital signals as outputs. So I am going to design digital systems, okay, with the help of logical gates and memory storage elements. So first of all, let me talk about the inputs that are digital signals. What is a digital signal? A signal which is a quantity which is varying over time. Okay, so here the digital signal, which is the quantity which is having only finite number of amplitudes. Okay, so such signals we call it as digital signals. A signal which is having only finite number of amplitudes. There are different types of digital signals. One is binary signals. The second one is ternary signals. Third one is quaternary signals. All these are digital signals. In binary signals, the quantity, it can have the only two amplitudes, only two possible amplitudes. Whereas in the ternary signals, the quantity will be having three amplitudes. In quaternary signals, the quantity will be having four amplitudes. In these three digital signals, the number of amplitudes are finite. Whereas in binary signals, the number of amplitudes are two, the number of amplitudes are 3 in ternary and quaternary 4. So these are the different digital signals. But in my digital system, I restrict myself to binary signals which are taking only 2 amplitudes, because which are very much similar to the states of the switch, which is having only 2 states, on and off state, and the state of the diode which is having forward bias and reverse bias. Okay, and the state of the transistor, I can drive the transistor into the cutoff and saturation region. So that's why I will take only the binary signals as digital signals. Now, in binary signals, there are only two amplitudes. So the more positive voltage, we take it as binary digit 1, and the lower voltage, we take it as the binary digit 0. So this kind of digital systems, we call it as positive logic digital systems. Whereas in negative logic digital systems, the more positive voltage we represented with negative, more positive voltage we represented with binary digit 0, and lower voltage we represented with binary digit 1 in opposite manner. So such type of digital systems we call it as negative logic digital system. Now here I take positive logic digital systems. So hereafter the binary digit 1, there are two binary digits. Two binary digits, one is 0 or 1. Now we can have different number systems. One is the traditional number system, that is decimal number system. Next, different types of number systems. One is decimal number system. Binary number system. Next, hexadecimal octal number system. Hexadecimal number system. So in traditional number system, that is decimal number system, the numbers have been formed by 4 10 digits. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Whereas in the binary number system, the numbers have been formed by 2 digits, one is 0, the other one is 1. Whereas in the octal number system, the numbers have been formed by 8 digits, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Whereas in the hexadecimal number system, the digits have been formed by 16 symbols, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, A, B, C, D, E, F. Clear? So, now, we are all familiar with decimal number system. So, today I will talk about how to convert the decimal number systems to binary number system and binary decimal numbers to octal and decimal number to hexadecimal number system. So, here I will convert the problem into two types. So non-decimal number system. How do we convert numbers from decimal number system to non-decimal number system? So, in decimal number systems, the numbers are formed by only the digits from that is 0 to 10. Whereas in the non-decimal number system, you can have different types of number systems, that is binary number system, and this is octal number system, and this is hexadecimal number system. So the procedure is same when we are converting decimal number to non-decimal number system. When we are converting decimal numbers to binary number system, in binary number system, the numbers have been formed by only two digits, one is 0 and the 1. So these two digits which we can get by the remainders when we divide any decimal number with 2. If we divide any decimal number with 2, these are the only possible remainders, 0 and 1. So, when we are dividing any decimal number, let me take here an example, that is, my decimal number is 23. The base is 10. So, how do I convert this decimal number to binary? So, what we do is, we divide this, the given decimal number with the 2, then we take the remainders. So, 23, when I divided with 2, 2 11s 22, here remainder, the possible remainders are 0 or 1. So, here I will get remainder 1. Next, when I divide 11 with 2, then 2 5s, then remainder is 1. When I divide this 5 with 2, then remainder is 1. So, 2 1s and remainder is 0 and 2 0s, remainder is 1. So, we take from bottom to top. So, the final equivalent representation for this 23 in binary, that is 10111 to the base 2. So, any number, any decimal number can be converted into non-decimal numbers by dividing by its respective base. For example, if you are converting a decimal number, the same decimal number 23, if you are converting it into octal decimal number system, then we have to divide the given decimal number with the base of octal number, that is 8. Then the possible digits which we can get as remainders, that is 0 to 7. So this is the technique that we follow when we convert decimal numbers to non-decimal numbers. Similarly, when we are converting decimal numbers to hexadecimal number, hexadecimal numbers have been formed by 16 symbols, 0 to 9 and A, B, C, D, E, F. So, A is nothing but in decimal value it is 10, symbol B, its decimal value is 11. Okay. So, this is how we convert any decimal number into non-decimal number by successive division, so that the remainders are the digits of the respective number system. The second problem is reverse problem. How do we convert the non-decimal numbers to decimal numbers? How do we convert the non-decimal numbers to decimal number? So let me take now the second problem is non-decimal numbers to decimal numbers. So here let me take three types of non-decimal numbers. One is binary numbers, okay, and the second one is octal number. So, how do we convert these non-decimal numbers to decimal numbers? So, here we take the corresponding weights, the positional values we take. For example, when we are taking the binary to the decimal numbers, let us take a binary number example. So the binary number that is 111 to the base 2, then what is its corresponding decimal number? So how do we get this? So each, from this is the LSB, that is the least significant bit, and this is the most significant bit. So we have to give the positional weights. So here the weight is 2 power of 0 and 2 power of 1, this is 2 power of 2, and this weight is 2 power of 3. Then the 1 into its corresponding weight, that is 2 power of 3, and this 1 into its corresponding weight, that is 2 power of 2, and this 1 into corresponding weight 2 power of 1 plus 1 into corresponding weight 2 power of 0, so that we will get 8 plus 4 plus 2 plus 1. So this is 15 to the base 10. So this is how we convert decimal, non-decimal numbers to decimal numbers. Then there are some problems. How do we convert? The conversion between, now the third problem is, how do we convert one non-decimal number to other non-decimal number? The conversion between two non-decimal numbers. Conversion between two non-decimal numbers. So this is one non-decimal number. Okay. And this is also a non-decimal number. Non-decimal number. So here, how do we convert? So how do we convert the binary numbers into octal numbers? Octal numbers. And how do we convert this binary number into hexadecimal number? Hexadecimal number. Clear? So the binary numbers, let me take an example, that is, so 1010 and 10 to the base 2 is a binary number which has been formed by two binary digits, ones and zeros. And what is its octal number? What is its octal number? So here, octal numbers, group of 33 binary digits, we take from the LSB side. From the LSB side, we take group of 33 bits. Okay, so 33 bits we take, and each octal digit, that is, there are 8 octal digits, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So each octal digit, the binary equivalent. So for octal digit, so these are the octal digits. So 0, that is nothing but 3 zeros, 1, that is 001, 2 is 010, and 3 is 011, 4 is 100, and 5, 101, and 6, 110, and 7, 111. So the 010, which corresponds to octal digit 2, so, and 101, which is corresponds to octal digit 5. So the answer is 52 to the base 8. So this is how we convert a non-decimal numbers to binary. Here we have taken binary to octal conversion. Next, binary to hexadecimal when we are converting. So here we have to take group of 44 bits. So how do we take this? So 8 can be written as, this is 2 power of 3. Then 16 can be written as 2 power of 4. So this power is decides how many number we have to take as a group. So when we are converting the binary numbers to hexadecimal number, we have to take group of 44 bits. Let me take the same binary number 101010. Now this, what is the equivalent of hexadecimal number? What is its equivalent of hexadecimal number? So again, you take from the 44 group of bits from the LSB side. Start from the LSB side. So this is 1. So here only 2 bits are available. Then we can append or we can add zeros, okay, to get 4 bits. Then here let me take the hexadecimal digits. Hexadecimal digits. There are 16 hexadecimal digits. So here, what is its binary equivalent? Binary equivalent. Okay. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, A, B, C, D, E, F. So this is A, B, C, D, E, F. Now 0 is represented with 4 binary digits. The hexadecimal digit 0 is represented with 4 binary digits, that is 4 zeros. And here 001, 0010, 0011, 0100, 0101, 0110, 0111, and 1 followed by 000, 1001, and 1010, 1011, and 1100, 1101, 1110, all ones. Now let me take the equivalent hexadecimal digit for the group of 4 binary digits. 1010, that is corresponds to A. So next, 0010 is corresponds to 2. So the hexadecimal digit, equivalent hexadecimal digit for the given binary number is 2A to the base 16. So this is how we convert the non-decimal numbers to the other non-decimal number. Okay. Okay. Next. There is one more standard problem, that is the problem is related to this number systems. This is 211 to the base x, that is equal to 152 to the base 8. So one side he has given, on the right hand side he has given octal number, on the left hand side the number the system he has not given. Okay, we have to find out this number is belongs to which number system. So how do we calculate? So how do we find the which number system this number belongs to? So for this the procedure is, so first this unknown number we will find out the equivalent decimal number. What is its decimal number? So this is non-decimal number. This problem now can fit into non-decimal numbers to decimal number. On the right hand side octal number also I will convert this into non-decimal number to decimal number, which we have just discussed how to convert a non-decimal numbers to decimal number. From these two, so these two numbers 211 to the base x, okay, is equal, therefore these two decimal numbers are equal, from that we can calculate the unknown number system. So let me proceed. So first, how do we convert the non-decimal numbers to decimal number? So we take the corresponding weights. So here the weight of this LSB is x raised to the power of 0, and here the weight of this 1 is x raised to the power of 1. Here the weight of 2 is x raised to the power of 2. So we take the weights, corresponding weights to each and every digit. Okay. Then the positional value for this digit 2 is, so 2 into x raised to the power of 2, and the positional value for digit 1 is 1 into x power of 1, and the positional value for the next one is 1 into x power of 0. So this is 2x square and this is x plus 1. So this is my decimal number. Okay. Now similarly I calculate 152 to the base 8, its decimal number. So we know that this digit 2 LSB, the corresponding weight is 8 power of 0, and this weight is 8 power of 1, and this weight is 8 power of 2. So the position value for this digit 1 is 1 into 8 power of 2 plus this 5 into 8 power of 1, and this for digit 2, the positional value, that is, this is 2 into 8 power of 0. So, this is 16 plus 40 plus 2. So, this is 58. This is here, 8 square is 64. So, 64, so this is 106. So, this is 106 to the base 10. Now, examiner has given, so these two are same numbers. So, the corresponding decimal numbers are equal. So, the decimal number of 211 to the base x is, that is 2x square plus x plus 1, and the decimal number of 152, that is 106 to the base 10. Now, once the bases are same, the corresponding numbers are equal. So, here 2x square plus x plus 1, that is equals to 106. Then 2x square plus x, this is equals to minus 105. So, this is 105 into 2, this is 15/7, 105. So, here I will be getting 2x square plus 15x and minus 14x minus 105 to the base 0 plus 2 is equals to 0. And let me take, so let me write here, this side is minus 14x. And here, let me take, this is 15x. So, 2x if I take common, this is x minus 7. And whereas here, if I take 15 common, this is x minus 7. So, x minus 7, 2x plus 15 is equals to 0. Therefore, x minus 7 is equals to 0, or 2x plus 15 is equals to 0. So, x is equals to 7, or x is equals to minus 15 by 2. But the number system cannot be a negative, so the value, that is x, is equals to 7. So, this number is belongs to base 7. So, this is how we calculated the unknown base also. Okay. So, this is about decimal number systems. So, a summary. Okay. Summary. So, we have defined what is a digital system. Digital system. And what is a digital signal. And why are we taking binary signals? Binary signals. Next. Then the binary numbers, there are different types of number systems. We discussed types of number systems. Types of number systems. Then conversion, that is decimal to decimal numbers to non-decimal numbers. Decimal numbers to non-decimal numbers. Conversion we discussed, non-decimal numbers. And that is non-decimal numbers to non-decimal numbers to decimal numbers conversion also we have discussed. And non-decimal numbers to non-decimal numbers conversion also we discussed. Non-decimal numbers. We have also discussed unknown base calculation. Unknown base calculation. For the given numbers. For the given numbers. Thank you for giving this opportunity.